of sex slaves, underage girls, a billionaire, murder, a prince, and at least one former U.S. president. What has been the biggest scandal in the U.K. since World War II has now come to the U.S., and it may involve former President Bill Clinton. The story surrounds this man, billionaire Jeffrey Epstein, who served time in 2008 for soliciting prostitution. That charge came as part of a plea deal. It all began in 2005 when Epstein was investigated after a woman reported that he paid her 14-year-old daughter $300 for sex. And since that initial claim, there have been more than 40 women who have come forward with claims that Epstein is a sexual predator and that he not only abused them, but shared them with famous and powerful friends. Well, flash forward to today, and a lawsuit is underway in Palm Beach, Florida. In that lawsuit, multiple mentions of former President Bill Clinton, who reportedly took multiple trips to Epstein's private island. You see it here. It's called Little St. James. It all happened between 2002 and 2005. Now, according to testimony in the lawsuit, at least one woman on that compound was there unwillingly. She is referred to as Jane Doe 102. She was forced to live as one of Epstein's underage sex slaves for years and was forced to have sex with politicians, businessmen, royalty, people working in academics, etc. Now, to be clear, in 2008, when the plea deal happened, Clinton cut off ties to Epstein, but maybe not. According to the UK Daily Mail, the lawsuit claims that Clinton was friends with an unnamed woman who kept images of naked underage children on her computer, helped to recruit underage children for Epstein, and photographed underage females in sexually explicit poses. Now, while Clinton cut off ties with Epstein, this woman's abuses apparently did not end their relationship, as she was reportedly one of the 400 guests at Chelsea Clinton's 2010 wedding. So what did Bill Clinton know? What was he a part of? According to The Smoking Gun, as part of a civil suit filed against Epstein by several of his victims, lawyers for the women floated the possibility of subpoenaing Clinton, since he might well be a source of relevant information about Epstein's activities. Now, while Clinton was never deposed, lawyers obtained Epstein's computerized phone directory, which included email addresses for Clinton, along with 21 phone numbers for him, including those for his assistant, Doug Band, according to a court filing. Now, I spoke earlier with Dennis Hoff, the owner of the Bunny Ranch in Nevada, and a man who personally knows Bill Clinton. In fact, Hoff photographed Clinton with two of his Bunny Ranch girls at a charity event in Los Angeles in March of last year. I asked Hoff if, with multiple trips to Little St. John Island, if there is any way that Bill Clinton was not aware of these underage girls.
I don't believe it's possible. It's amazing that this happened and came to light. And I don't think Bill Clinton would ever want to be involved with an underage girl. But the fact that it's happening in front of his eyes and that the Secret Service guys didn't do something about it is shocking.
21 phone numbers as well as email addresses that were reportedly belonged to him that were in possession of Jeffrey Epstein. What does that say to you?
Well, it says that this Epstein is just an absolute disgusting pig. I mean, to be messing around with underage girls, it's just unbelievable. Now, I give Bill Clinton a little bit of a pass because, look, he had other parties after this all happened, and who went to it? Stephanopoulos, Katie Couric, Woody Allen, which is not a good sign, I guess, and Chelsea Handler. So it could be possible that Clinton did not know about this, but it's almost hard to believe.
And that party that Hoff mentions there was just one party as compared to the multiple visits by Bill Clinton. But this story is much bigger than just former President Clinton. Prince Andrew, the Duke of York, is being connected to this scandal as well. In 2001, Virginia Roberts, a 17-year-old who now claims to have been held as Epstein's sex slave, was introduced to Prince Andrew while staying at a London home. Ms. Roberts claims that she was paid £10,000 as a reward for having sex with Prince Andrew by Epstein. I spoke earlier with RT UK presenter Afshin Ratanzi, and he says that the scandal around Prince Andrew is growing daily.
It is definitely building in the infamous British tabloid press, who are kind of at war with the royal family as the general election campaign here proper begins. It is a kind of old story, but of course we are getting further facts because of the plaintiff, in effect.
Now, in the UK, this story, though, is a lot larger than just Jeffrey Epstein and Prince Andrew. In fact, it seems like it involves this pedophilia ring that reaches into the highest levels of British society, including presenters with the BBC, including members of Parliament. It seems like this is a growing story that involves some 1,400 kids. Can you tell me a little bit about that and the development over the last year into that story?
Yeah, around the world, the headlines from Britain tend to, in the international newspapers, seem to make out that Britain is this center of upper-class paedophilia. And indeed, the press here also reflecting those stories. There is a certain degree of frenzy about it, it has to be said. But at the same time, the story keeps giving, because the latest, quite apart from the fact that there have been entertainers jailed, quite apart from the fact that close confidants of the powerful have been jailed, top public relations people and so on, now the story seems to be concerning not only paedophile rings, but actually murder, and murder so close to the Palace of Westminster itself, the so-called Mother of Parliaments. So these cases are ongoing. And
can you define for us the murder charge? That goes back to a young man who was believed to have died during one of these orgies, is that correct?
That's right. There's testimony that's now being investigated as to whether rent boys, I suppose, the murder of rent boys by prominent politicians with people being named. But I think it's very important to emphasize the fact that all the accusations tend to be on people who've died. It's as if the police and the Scotland Yard has its own headlines as regards covering up things in this country. It's so scandalous that even the government here, the Home Secretary Theresa May, has been criticizing the Police Federation for the past year or so. And we know that Scotland Yard has been involved in cover-up after cover-up relating to so many different aspects of British civic life. So as regards current serving politicians, every time it seems to touch a serving British politician, the story seems to dwindle. And again, we talk about stories of past ministers, particularly in Margaret Thatcher's cabinet during the 1980s.
Well, as the story grows, it becomes more and more apparent this is not just a story of underage girls. It is the story of a massive pedophilia ring involving some of the most powerful people in the world. Back to Jeffrey Epstein, because when police were investigating Epstein in 2008, they found an Amazon.com invoice for the purchase of sex slave books, such as Slavecraft, Roadmaps for Erotic Servitude, Principles, Skills, and Tools. Another called Training with Ms. Abernathy, a workbook for erotic slaves and their owners. And SM101, a realistic introduction. I spoke with Kambiz Shambankari, who has spent years covering sex trafficking all around the world, and I asked him what this scandal is demonstrating about the power and the abuse of people from around the world.
You know, the fact is, regardless of what's happening right now with Prince Andrew and Epstein, you know, that's a long time that a community of wealthy people, they take advantage of underage children and girls especially. There was based on United States government document, there were more than 600,000 cases of human trafficking, that more than 60% of them, they were girls that they brought to United States. Thailand has one of the worst cases in this matter, that many rich people, they travel to Thailand to have sex with underage children. And in this case, for Miss Roberts' case, she was 17, but we are facing in Thailand with something like 6 years old or 5 years old kids that they have been used as sex slaves.
Well, and it just seems like this is, and as you pointed out, and I think you make a great point, that at the end of the day, a lot of the girls who are involved in this particular story, and that's not to minimize the abuse of them, are much older, and yet there are very young children all around the world that this is happening to, even as we're speaking.
Yeah, that's true. But what is bothering me about this case is blaming the victim. That's what we see a lot, you know.
How so? How are they blaming the victim?
They started to bullying the this woman.
When you say that, are you talking specifically about Alan Dershowitz, the attorney who's now been assigned to this case, now taking it
on? Exactly. And she's you know, Miss Roberts is an example of many of those victims that they can't step forward. They can't talk about their abusers. They can't talk about what happened to them because they are afraid.
Well, that person who is now blaming the victims, as you heard there, according to Sean Bankari, is attorney Alan Dershowitz, who himself has now been accused of having sex with underage girls associated with Epstein. Writing in the Wall Street Journal Law blog that he is the victim of an extortion conspiracy, Dershowitz is calling for the disbarment of the two lawyers who are representing the alleged victims. It's a story we'll continue to follow.
Private jet at the center of a sex scandal making lurid headlines across the world. Sleazy Wall Street tycoon Jeffrey Epstein used the Lolita Express to ferry a bevy of beautiful young women. Among the passengers, former President Bill Clinton and Britain's Prince Andrew.
On almost every trip that I did go on, there were young girls around.
In this Inside Edition exclusive, Shantae Davies takes us inside the secret world of the Lolita Express, named for the controversial book and movie about a professor's infatuation with an underage girl. Shantae made several trips on Jeffrey Epstein's infamous Lolita Express. She says she was one of several young, attractive women hired to travel around the world giving massages or yoga instruction to Epstein and his rich and powerful friends. When Shantae was hired, she was a struggling 22-year-old actress. She once played a lingerie model in a movie called Exposed.
These designs are really great.
Shantae worked as a masseuse, but says she never had sex with Epstein.
Did you ever think that maybe more was going on than simple massages?
Looking back, of course.
Was there a bed on the airplane?
Actually, yes, there was, yeah.
On one memorable flight on board a plane like this provided by Air Hollywood, she says she made peanut butter and jelly sandwiches for passengers, including Oscar winner Kevin Spacey, actor Chris Tucker, and even Bill Clinton. They were all flying to Africa on a humanitarian mission, and Jeffrey Epstein had given them the use of his jet.
So you never gave President Clinton a massage?
No, I didn't.
Shantae says when the plane landed in Africa, Clinton took her shopping, but she says nothing improper occurred.
They had shut down a jewelry store for us, and I helped him pick out a bracelet for Chelsea.
It was a jet-set lifestyle for sure, but Shantae says she felt uncomfortable about being part of Epstein's collection of young women.
You saw young women around Jeffrey Epstein, and they didn't seem to have regular jobs, and you started wondering, why are they here?
Yes, yes.
When you look back, are there red flags that you should have seen at the time?
Definitely, yeah. Why fly anyone out to be a masseuse when there's plenty of masseuses in the same city that you're in?
Epstein served 13 months in prison for soliciting an underage girl for prostitution. Now just looking at the front page headlines the scandal has generated brings Shantae to tears.
To have to deal with that and then on top of it defend my character, I'll have children one day, you know, and they'll read this.
She wonders whether she'll ever be able to live down her time on the Lolita Express.
More than anything, I just felt stupid. Yeah, I felt duped.